So, now that I've gotten the phone or the camera all charged up, I'm on to the next part, which is actually building this whole thing. So, I got my bench all there. I have to actually remove. I think I have to remove. Yeah, I have to remove the cooler, which is fine. Which means I have to remove the GPU as well. But for now, I'm just going to set that aside. I have my nice little cloth. I don't have like a sheet to use, so I went and used an old t-shirt of mine and cut it up. So I have a... So... This guy is... It's rather weighty, and... because you're not gonna see much for a second, or two, or three, until I actually get this thing out of the box. Should be that hard. I don't want to break the bag like I just did. Okay, I'm just gonna bring this upside down. Because that's exactly what I think needs to be done. Yeah, I should be able to slowly lift this thing up. It just doesn't want to go today. Oh, here it goes. Shake it a little bit. Go. And I'm going to disappear for a second. And there we go. So, yes, my case is upside down. I purposely did that for a reason. When I put it in, or when I was checking this stuff out, how this case works and everything, it does, it, this thing is like snug with the foam here, and my case is pretty well all metal, so. I don't have the tempered glass stuff that some people would have. It's not a priority with me, so I never went with that. So I wanted something a little bit more streamlined and such, so I went with the Antec P10. P10 Flex. That goes in there, and I'm probably going to be putting this back in the box when I'm done. It has a magnet side, or magnet front panel. I've already pre-installed the, let me turn this around. Look. So you guys can see what it looks like on the inside. So I already pre-installed the DVD player. And all the fans are pre-installed as well, and I am probably going to keep that shut for now. And that's the one thing I do like about this, is that you can keep this shut, you can have it open, doesn't matter. I am going to take one of these USB things right now, before I forget, before I mess up things. I have a USB 3.2 on my motherboard that... Will it take? Will it come off? It should just come off. And that's just part of the thing. Surprise me. Yeah, it should come off. I'll move my motherboard a little bit. Is it actually pulled? The board. Nope. Okay. Or is it? It actually... Yep, it is part of the board. Okay, fine. Good to know now. I'm going to have to go through this in a second. taking off the thumb screws, so I have those done. So what I'm doing with that little USB cover thing is making sure that the BIOS one is covered. I don't want to accidentally okay, how do you remove the cover? Can the cover be removed? Just quickly saying. Okay. I want to install the thing into the thing. That's the motherboard over there. Okay. Install the motherboard into the. Yeah, I have to go back into the motherboard settings and turn off a couple of the things that I forgot. Yeah, it's in the boot section. I want to make sure that's so that stuff is off. I have to do the right stuff after I've built this thing. Okay, so what I need is in here. So I need to take the two thumb screws off, and I don't know why they call them that, but there's four of them, but I need two of them. Oh, that's for the HDMI port. It's like, what the heck is that? This little guy here is for HDMI, and I'm going to actually put it where the HDMI port is on the motherboard side, because I don't need it. There we go. So I got the BIOS point off, and this is the big panel. I wanted to make sure that stuff is off. I am going to have to unplug the. There, this is a lot of room. I'm just going to toss this off screen. Actually, no, I can toss it in the box. Haha. I put thing in box. Okay. Grab this thumb screw. Now what's neat about this is that there's a phone jack or a jack for the microphone as well as a headset, so that is kinda cool. And if you notice on this panel, it does have a magnetic filter, so I'm able to make sure that filters are changed. There. So my four screws off. I'm gonna go through and make sure that I unscrew and such. I did a really terrible job with this. I was trying to get wires all set up and such. Okay. Sorry for the noise. This is going to be a very interesting little setup here. So, this cable is supposed to be for the. Let me turn this around for you guys. So, this is where the DVD player is. So, I've already installed it. I just have to do the thing, and I did a bit poor job of doing all these wiring stuff, so I'm gonna undo all these wires and rewire everything at a later time near the end of this build. So what I'll do is I'll put it back on my roll here, and I like using Velcro ties rather than twist ties. It's just, A, it's easier, because then you can really adjust, you don't really have to untwist and then retwist and then untwist. These just stick together. So I need to put you, and whatever you are, onto this side, is the mount. Okay, so I need to undo this. I know with some of this stuff I can this. Okay, so I'm gonna undoing all the cables I don't need right now. I'm gonna do the cables later. I need my screwdriver. So still don't understand why there's a thumb for here. I literally don't understand what that's for. Ah, it's the slime things. Okay, so those two will go over there for now. So that's just interesting. I'm just removing that for now before I do anything. Check one of these guys out. I'm definitely gonna do the black one because I. Even though it, technically you don't need these, I still want to be safe. Rather be safe than sorry. And until I actually do the hook up the power and such, I want to make sure that I'm that. So before I start doing all the thing, all the rigmarole, I really like that they give you a microfiber. I'll grab myself in just a hot second. It's also why I don't have a shirt off. I'm basically in a tank top right now. Because I want to limit the amount of static charge. So, I'm just going to undo all these little things. I'll do the cable management at the very, 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 very last bit. So, I'm just going to add this to. And like I do with all my Eclipse Kitchen episodes, this is going to be like, the only cuts you're going to see are the, I'm going to use this one here for my bottom drive, which I'm going to do in a hot second here. Still have one more. Oh, for crying out loud. There. So I'm just getting all my cables free. So here. There we go. But yeah, this is going to be a very interesting build. I'm just putting my cables away. There we go. Okay, so just make sure that I got everything. Can I actually unplug these guys? If I can unplug the cable. Don't know if I can. I don't think I can. It doesn't look like it. Okay, fine. I won't unplug that one. Got those cables undone. I got those cables undone. I got. These cables already, I have the power cables and such already separated, I don't worry. Just remember what this one is. So those two are the power. What is this big guy here? Let's get it as two, okay, so that's the audio. So, HD audio. I hope that's already on there. It's like, wait. What is this cable? Oh, right, it's this. Okay. So I got all my cabling taken out. And there's nothing on this side, right? Yeah. Okay, so nothing on that side. I got my anti-static stuff. This is the accessory box. And I have enough for a third drive. I got 1 and 2 installed. I'm just going to show you guys quickly how I do the main one. Which is on this side. I got one already ready to go. I'm going to show you guys. Luckily, this is a picture. gonna show you guys exactly how this is going. I'm gonna move these cables out of the way for now and unplug this one. Because this case, also really, really good thing. It has its own controller for the this is the state of power that you need for the controller for the thingy. So on this side, I'm gonna go on this side here. And there's two screws here. I'm just gonna undo those two, show you how this is all set up. That is what you need to do. So with this, it's just undo two screws. This one here has, okay, let me off-screen this. So basically, I really gotta undo this, but basically you wanna line your drive up so it's flush on this side, and then just basically screw in those four holes. This also is set for the 2-inch or 2.5-inch. I just have my 3-inch, I think this one is 4 terabytes. So what you want to do is make sure that it's connection side up rather than down, and then you just line it up to the little nudges, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, boom, and then that's basically that, and then you secure it with the screws. So that's just a quick thing for this. So that's basically that hard drive done. This one was a nightmare getting in, because I had to go through, hold it on one side, had my hand through this hole here where the motherboard goes, and it was a bit of a nightmare trying to get that. So that's that. Let's see how I'm gonna do this part. All these cables here are gonna just sit off to the side. I'm gonna bring this back down. So this way, keep that cable where it is. Cause this is like fully able to see this part. I'm gonna actually turn it around so you guys can see on this side how everything is. And I'm gonna probably work on that side. Actually, can I unplug this? I can unplug it. Good. Just wanna make sure that those types of plugs are done. I have the other set. These are really weird connections, but I'm gonna actually set this down, and hopefully you guys can see what this will look like. I'm gonna flip this case for that. And, okay, fine. You go under there. Cables. I don't need you yet. Is that missing my shirt? I just want to make sure that my cables aren't gonna get munched. So, hopefully you guys can see. Okay. Here, let me bring this closer.
I wonder if I can. Can I actually work it? No. Can I? What does this do? Sorry, I'm pointing my camera a little bit. Okay, so that is maxed out. Okay, I'm gonna get a better angle here. Hopefully I can get close enough. I have like my roommate. Some bottles everywhere. Let me get move some stuff here, and then I can hopefully bring, I'm gonna bring the camera as close as I can, so bear with me for a second. I think that's as close. I'm gonna get it. Wonder if I can rotate this. Oh, I can. Cool. I might be able to actually get it closer. Sorry, I'm trying to find this out. Perfect. There we go. Now you should be able to see. Yep. Okay. So you're not going to be able to see me per se, but you should be able to see the. I just want to make sure that you can see kind of in that vicinity there. Okay, so yes, you can see all the in there. Good. So this is basically this. I'm going to make sure that I have all the spacers in the right spots. I need a... I think this thing has ratchets, so... bigger one. Okay. It's the much bigger one. It's the 4.5, isn't it? Nope, it's 5. Really? It's a 5? Or is it 5.5? Nope, it's 5. Okay, cool. So, screwdriver. Take out the bit that I need. It's the 2. And put my bits away for a second. This guy is a built-in ratchet, so what I want to do before I do a thing, actually I need that 2 again. Let me grab the 2 that I needed. Yeah, doesn't matter which one. Because I very much need to I'm just gonna move this way before I do the thing. I need to bring this back in the shot for a second. Camera's a little crooked. Sorry. I didn't realize that my camera was crooked. Oh, there we go. Ha! So I have the down in the stands. Okay, cool. So I'm just gonna remove the cooler and possibly the board if I can figure out how to do the thingy. Yeah, okay. Can I actually open the board? I'll probably have to open, probably have to take these guys off, which is fine. So, taking the CPU coolers off. There we go. Because I need to make sure that these guys. Can I actually... Oh, come on. Where's the... Ugh. This is like way the hell in there. I'm just gonna see if I can... Luckily this thing is off. I can't do it. Okay. Can I go over this way? So once I actually... There we go. Good. I can pull my graphics card off. I'm gonna pull it off for a moment. On over here because I need to get full access to. So why is it this one? Okay. Weird. Okay. So, I need to make sure that this stuff goes back in afterwards. There we go. And this goes that way. I'll just put it this way for now. And then I get to, where's the other ratchet? Oh, there it is. I was like, I lost my ratchet. No, it's right here. So I just need to take the heat sink off, I think. Actually, I might not be able to. Oh, no, I don't think I need to.
I just need to take the fans off. Okay, cool. So, this is not... So, this plate is not coming off. Which is interesting, because normally when you do a... How the hell am I going to do this? Normally when you do a motherboard plate, you do the... This is a full ATX, so it should be. I should be able to put this all the way in. And I'm making sure that I'm not, like, getting any. Okay, why am I hitting resistance here? It's this thing here. Okay. Because for some reason, that's why I'm off. There we go. Now it should be on everything. Good. And there's already posts in there. That's one good thing about this case. They're ready to put everything that you need on here. So. So there should be 2, 3, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm actually going to need my light in for a second. I don't think I am. I need my light. Give me my light, thank you. So, screw hole, screw hole, screw hole. Screw hole, screw hole, screw hole. Looks like they all have their screw holes. Okay, so I do have all posts. So now my instructions. I need my instructions. So I have the instructions on how to put the motherboard in, I think. Somewhere in here. But they don't tell you what type of screws they need. Oh, I see them. Okay. So it's either one or two. I think it's the fine ones. I hope it's the fine ones. I'll have to test. This is number one. Okay, so I need P1. And I'm gonna keep it fully, or keep my thing fully extended. Just wanna make sure. Gonna test one, make sure. Because what you do is you... Okay, that's not it. So it's not the tiny, fine ones. It's gotta be... It's not these guys. It's the other. I have so many of these screws. I just have to figure out which one is which. Might be these guys here. Alright, so one. Or is that the... Let's see. So it might be the bigger head screws. Three. Do I have 9 in here? These really, really fine ones. Which are these guys? Where's these ones? No, it's these ones. For 5, I need... Sorry, just give me a second. I'm looking at screws to see... I have all the fine ones. Those already had the posts in them, so it should be. Actually, can I actually bring this motherboard back out? Okay, good. That's the one thing I like about this. These fins are really, really, really good. Okay, fine. I'm holding it by the heatsink. or put the back plate, so. Okay. So what I want to do is test these guys. Because these are all the holes, right? So, do I actually need to put the post in? Okay. So it is these guys. I only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Unless I use, let's see, can I do these small screws? Okay, so how many of these guys do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I have 1, 2, 3. 3 posts, really? 3 posts for the small screws. Okay, so I might have to do a little of engineering here. Okay. Fine. 11.5. Which means that I'm going to do the 4 corners. So this one, what do we have, right? I have 5, right? So we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which means I need to do this one with the smaller one. So that one's doing the small one. So the big ones are going to be on the outside. I want to make sure that this is like fully secure, so I'm doing like one at a time. Replacing the big ones with the small one. How's the small one exactly fit? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's 1, 2. Should I have one more post? So that'd be that corner one. So three that are going to be big posts. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? 6, 7. Yep. It looks like I'm missing 3. Which is fine. I can do this, so. These are all in place, right? 1, 2, 3, I need that one. It's the same one, I guess. There we go. So, I'm going to remember where my placement is. So, 3 top, so those 3 there, and then these 2. Here we go again with the motherboard, and I'm going to grab it where the 1 piece is so I can go like this. Hopefully I can get this. Get my hand out. Did I bend any of the pins? No, good. And then I just like, oops. God, these things are a little more hardy nowadays. Oops. Nowadays. There. Okay, so that should line up everything else. Good. So what I'll do is I'll do the. Oops. Don't need that one. I need 2. Right. That's my number 2. Was it a 1? Oh, that's the start. What am I grabbing? Okay, it's the 2. I'm going to grab the 2. There we go. It's like, what's going on here? Okay. So, what I'll do is I'll
is a... That one... I'm not tightening them yet. I'm just making sure that they go in. I'm not afraid that these things will... I want them tight, but not like too tight. So I don't want to crack this board. So I'm just throwing in, and I'm just going to a quarter turn bigger. Okay. So I'm gonna need my little wiggly room thing. So what's that one? So the three, and then I'm doing the corner here. Here. Because I don't have the big guys, and the way they do the instructions on this isn't exactly. Yeah, I'll do that one last. Okay, where's my wiggly worm? Wiggly worm's on the other side. This is why I have wiggly worm. And I call it that because it lets me do parts where I can't go. Such as right underneath the cooler. It's not like you have to have every single one, but I want to make sure that I have every single one. So, they give me all these little bits and bobs, and I'm like, because I want to make sure that this does not decide to. And that's where I'm tightening on now. Because now comes the fun part. As soon as I... Oh, I'm missing one small one. And then one of these. I'm using my finger as a guide here. Okay. And that board should be... Yep, it's wrenched tight, good. So that's that. Now I get to remove that screw here. This is the thing about my screwdriver. So I can change the size, so. Again, anything that I'm not gonna be using. And now I have two extra screws, don't I? Pretty sure I need two extensions open. Yeah. So I'm just undoing the two that I need. I think what that other plate was is a lock for this. There we go. That should be enough. That should be wide enough, right? Yeah, it's too wide, so Or did I open the wrong one? Did I open the wrong one? No. It's the PCI, okay. I'm trying to find where the PCI slot is. There it is. Oh, I see. Oh, no, okay. So I did do one too many. All cards are different, so I just need the middle one. Okay. So I need that one there. That's fine. So I didn't need this one after all. So. I just need the one open, not the other. Which is fine. I don't mind. That's how narrow my card is. So, I think I just need, or do I need to? It's been a while since I've actually had to do this. Okay. Thank you. So, let's see. Okay, so I need this one open. It's not the top one, it's the other one. Okay, so I do need to open. I didn't think I did, and then realized, oh yes, I do. I just opened the wrong expansion. So, yeah. Sorry, I'm gonna move this a little bit farther back so you guys can see. What I'm doing here. So, I'm just taking out the second expansion. I did need to take out two, I just didn't take out the right two. So, these guys are gonna be back in there, so I need to separate them. I don't know if I need any of those other screws. They give me a lot of screws for this, so. Okay. There we go. So, those two screws, where's my screwdriver? Just make sure that this stays in place by wrenching in one way, and then where's the other screw? Still can't believe this. It's what, it's 5:45 my time right now. I did pretty good progress. I mean, I already have the motherboard in, and I have full access to all the ports that I need, so yay for that. So, what's the next part on my instructions? Because I just put the part of the board in. Yep. So the pin, I have full access to everything. This is another reason why I like this case more than the other stuff. Because I have access to every port that I need. Whether it's from underneath, whether it's from on top. The only thing I have to do here, which I forgot to do, is where's that thing? So, label side. So if I want this way. Okay, this is where the posts are. Okay. So I need four of them. They came with eight of the long posts, but I only need four, so. And I've already figured out how to do this. When I first got the case, that's the first thing I learned, or taught myself. And then it was how to put these guys in. Now, normally you would do this first, and then, but I want to make sure that the cable is that way. Label side down, because when you're label side, that's where the stuff is. So I'm gonna undo this cable for now. I don't think I need any of those other doodads, because I got everything except for the NVMe, and I think I'll have to, when I get the SATA drive for the operating system and programs and such, I'll have to put that back in. And I'll have to pop up the fan back under. I have to unplug that thing anyways. I just realized I forgot to put the fans back on for the CPU. So right now it's just a big, huge heat wave. So that's fine. At least I know where everything is. I can have access to that little hole. So, this. So I don't need the other. All the other screws I don't need because I got my motherboard in, and the only screws that I actually need is just right there. So yeah, I have an extra bay, and it's one of those toolless bays. Well, you can put screws in it if you want, but you don't really need to. You just put the three, you can do three or two in here. The two, you need the screws, but for the three, it's... You don't really need to, and that's why there's so many freaking screws. Again, I like this company. This Antec is really good for their making sure that you have everything. So what I'll do is I'll put all this extra bits and such. It's like these two things here that came with the box. So I got everything else. Set up except for the reverse fan, and that's what I'm working on right now. So yeah, I got the DVD instructions. I don't need anything else in terms of instructions. Power supply, I already know how to do. I already got that done. So CPU is done. Making sure, okay, the SATA drive, well, I got all the drives done. It's just the reverse one I have to do. So, I need to unscrew this other bolt here. I'll put this back on its side afterwards. I just want to get this one out, get the GPU. Okay, where's the... Latch is doing latch things. If I can grab it. Oh. Come on. I have to like pull it back and then. Fine, right? Since you are able to fit back there. There we go. So I'm just gonna put this to the side because I need to lift this guy up for a second. And I have plenty of room. I think I should be able to do the NVMe microns. And then I'll have to undo the CPU again. This guy. So I want this side down. I'm going to be going on this side so you guys can see how I'm doing this. Hopefully I'm not going to be out of the way, or in the way, for this. Just not going to... Okay, yeah. Hopefully I'm not going to be in the way. Okay, good. So, basically, I want to put my fan here. So, luckily I have the thing I want. I just want to put this one in first, line up the hole, and then screw. Not screw tight yet, but... This one here, oh. I'm very lucky that I have a very, very skinny, hello, where's my, I'm gonna put my wiggly worm on, and that's what I call this thing, because it wiggles like a worm, so if I need a little bit of extra bit, I got it. That. This one. It's just a good one for that. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do the other one as well. So I'm gonna do this. And the reverse fan, it'll just pull the hot air down and then out. This is why I like this one because oh shoot. Off the seriously. So I could potentially, if I want to. If I really want to. Okay, that's it. I could put the... Shoot, I put the fan in wrong. Okay, let's do this dance again. Either way. Thank you. Come on. And why I say I put it in wrong? I wanted to have the fan cable going that way. I should have paid attention. Oh well. Thing is very easy to. Look, I didn't reach this one. Okay, and then this one. At least you can see how this is going to be. Okay, so want the fan, want the cables down that way. Okay, let's do the wiggly worm one first. AKA, I want to do this one first. And then, I have to find where the wall is. Sorry, I'm kind of in the way for a second. Okay, that one works. I'm able to line up everything else. Good. So I'm doing these two, I'm doing this next part here. Doing this side. This corner one too. That way I have my fans. Always do it corner to corner. So do it in like an X pattern. And then you'll never have to worry about. And I'm tightening them as much as I can. So, yeah, as you can see, I got plenty of room to plug in everything. One that I don't like. Which I'm really, really not looking forward to. Is the... What I'm not looking forward to is all these guys down here. I wanted a fan. I got a fan. That's that part. Gonna move you guys back. Look. Make sure that this is there. And then I'm gonna... Because I'm gonna continue doing... Things that I'm gonna... That way. So you guys can see. Because I'm gonna go ahead and do... A couple of things. First, put the other back on without crushing all my cables. This is where it's gonna take a while. Goodness, I have a big oops. Yeah, it's called. I need to make sure that all my cables are under here. And oh no, there's a little upstairs. Okay. Good. Okay. So I got that back in. Now I can do my graphics card. Really like the design of this thing. Okay. There it is. Hear the pop. It's ready to go. Hear the pop. It's dropped. There. See? Now I got the motherboard in, I got the thing in, I got everything in and ready. So it has the cover built in, which is interesting with this motherboard. So now I have to do the fans. And since I want the fans to go that way. That's right. Should be able to. if I did this right. Don't tell me I have to actually. Okay, fine. I'll. If you think you're done, no, of course not. okay. I'm getting very proficient in trying to get this thing. In undoing the graphics card. at least this is getting done. Hopefully I can be able to have this guy plug in. I have to figure out where the SATA cables are again. Oh, there. So all my SATA cables are down by the graphics card. Okay. Now, because Wright is better at this fishing for the... Seriously? Look how they got small fingers. I'm being very efficient in, okay, I'm just making sure that I didn't, okay, let's do, so you go, yeah, that's right. It's neat, if you look on the Noctua, they actually have arrows where the airflow is actually going, so it's going sticker side out. That's exactly what you want, is sticker side out. In. Almost all in. Here we go. And you're in. Okay, cool. So let's play this one in the auxiliary one. So that fan is done. Clearly this motherboard has two fans. Or two spots for fans. And then I want to go one notch. Oh, for freak's sake. Seriously, I did not. Okay, fine. This is more of a two-person round. Okay. And this one should be able to hold in place. Careful because those long pins tend to they tend to break easily. Good, so I made this very snug. So check. This is the one that has the no, it's the other one. I just want to make sure that I have clearance. I'm pretty sure I have clearance. Oops, this way. I just want to see how much. Oh, frick. I got like millimeters of clearance. Good. I really packed in this tight. Holy crap. I just want to make sure that this was not higher than where the thing is, and it's not good. Okay, let's try this dance a third time. Okay. Well, at least I got everything in now. I'm gonna get my water in a second. He's thirsty. I put that in crooked. That's such a ditz. I'm gonna use Wiggly Worm. And that's what I'm calling this thing. It's just.
It's a funner name, and it's... I like fun, so... There we go. This makes it easier, so I can flex. Flex this without having to worry too much. There we go. So, I got that ready, I'm going to bring, I don't need any of those. SATA drive, I'm probably going to have to, I'll have to take out the graphics card. Okay, I don't know once I do this, once I get the SATA drive, I'll have to pop this one off because I'll be able to, wiggle worm the other. Okay, what's next on my list? Graphics cards in. Okay, tighten all the screws. Plug in the header cable. Okay. The other I attached to your mix. 32. So the really, really tiny ones that I was putting in there. Those are the 632s. Those are very, 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 very small. Let's see. That. Okay, tighten all the screws. I did that. Plug in the headers. Okay, so. Now I could just stand this guy up. Oopsie daisy. And I'm gonna go like that because all the cables that I need are right there. So, that's that. I'm gonna turn this to the side. Because when they're saying the headers, they mean like the front I.O. So, the front I.O. and such. So, what I don't need is the fan. So the fan right now, I can plug that one back in. Did they really do that? I did too. Why? Can I actually unplug? If I can unplug these guys, I... Nope. I don't think I can. Nope. I wish I could, because then I can pop it off. Okay, fine. So, this one is the fan. The fan. Since this is a different type of header. You okay? You want to twist? I don't want to twist. I want you to go here. Make sure that I get this lined up correctly and pop that in. There we go. So that's done. Since I'm not doing the SSD here, I don't need to worry about that. Just let that lay flat under there. For shits and giggles, I'll just leave it there. I'll do a tie there. Okay, front I.O. So, where's my little... This little piece is very, very helpful. Okay. HD audio. Sound. Up again. Okay. Okay, power. Power positive, power negative. Okay, so power negative goes there. Power positive. Oh, power lady. Oops. Power switch. Power switch there. So let's these guys make sure powering. This is actually really helpful, this little thing. So what I'm doing is okay, hard drive light. Hard drive goes in that back one. Come on, hard drive. In the hole, there we go.
reset. Where's the reset? Fan, okay. So I got all those, and I don't need the cable tie right now. So what this one will do is allow me to pop in everything. I'll cable tie everything later. But this is... Sorry you guys aren't seeing this. I'm just like trying to get this to fit. So I have HD audio. I just have to figure out where the HD audio goes. Where's my rule of... So yeah, this is gonna take... It's gonna take a while. So, every time I don't need a thing... Okay, so... Okay, what's this? That's fan number 5. Right, so, I need to go fan number 5, which is right... this right. There we go. So I have enough for one more fan if I need to. And conveniently, it just kind of stays at the top. So what else do I need for one of these guys? Okay, so SATA cables. I'm not doing the power cables yet. That's going to come last. It's the SATA data cables, that's the ones I'm going to be doing next. I think I only have 3. So, this is the straight on. So this one will be going, where's the, okay, so you will be going through, that's it. So, literally, I just have to, you guys aren't being able to see. Okay, I'm gonna go behind here and then you guys can see what the heck I'm doing. So, actually I need to see too. So basically, this is a hard drive. Just want to make sure that this goes that way. And then I'm going to bring half of it through. Make sure that my L is the other way. There we go. I'm going to do this one on the very bottom. Oh, I see. I'm going to have to do this one. Where's the L? L one there. Okay. I'm gonna do the L shaped one because it's gonna be easier. It's like, which way is it? See, L, it's up, it's down. So it should fit. Okay, I'm gonna do this one here. Oh, no, I can't. Never mind. I'm going to do, you know, I need to do the other one. Okay, L shaped that way. It's going to take me a little bit here. There we go. So that's that one. And this is going to go into L shape. Where are you? You L shape? See. Sorry, I'm gonna have to tip this a little bit.
Tip it forward so I can see. I'm trying to see L this way.
There. Okay. So I have the L shape there. Sorry, I'm gonna have to. There, okay. Hard drive 1 is in. Hard drive 2. So this is HD audio. HD audio. Power. Easy. Okay. So where's the reset switch? That's the. These guys were just HD audio, that's separate. So HD audio goes there. So where's the reset button? This one doesn't have a reset button. Okay. Interesting. So this goes underneath and up, I think. Go from this side. Thank goodness I haven't put the power. Where'd you go, Kate? There you go. Okay. So I do go up. I think it's this one here. So. Okay. I have to find which hole it is. Okay. I'm going to twist this so I can see. Okay. Have to rethink this reverse fan. I think I can do this without. And I'm actually looking because that's the USB. Because the USB header is this guy here. It needs to go up and around. So I need to go up. And this one is the 3, which is right. Yeah, I might have to put it here. Because this is the... Yeah, this is the long pin. This is... Okay. Let's see. Do I have to undo? I do. Okay, fine. When you think I'm done with trying to do all this... I'm going to bring this over here for a second. When you think I'm done with the... graphics card spot. No, of course not. And really, I don't think I need that. As of yet. Because I'm not staticky, so you go over there. Of course. Right. Shirt is all tangled up. As per usual. Oh well, this is why I use a shirt. So I had to do again. Here I thought I was done with the graphics card. No. Apparently I need to. I'm gonna be an expert in removing the external hard drive. Late. Holy crap. Okay. It's at an angle that I can't really... Crap. To the right. Or to the back. Yeah. There we go. So I should be able to... Haha, I'm a real expert now of this hard drive, holy crap. So I need to remove this. Remove it for now. Seriously. I can pull it out. I might actually have to not have this fan in. I am thinking I won't have the room. Which is fine. I don't mind. I don't mind not having a fan there. Jeez. So, yeah. I'm gonna just remove this. I thought I would be able to. I really wanted to, but now this is just not. It's not going to work, so. It's gonna fall on the other side, anyways. Well, I have an extra fan, apparently. Which is fine, I don't mind. It's just, I think that's meant for like the small form factor ones. Or smaller motherboards. It ain't working well with this one. There we go. Yeah, okay. So that was number 5. Well, at least I have enough for 2 more. So this is not going to be a thing, unfortunately. That's right. At least I have an extra fan for another time. So that's my other issue. Okay, so now that I actually have access, which one do I need? On the tool on the bottom. Okay. On the tool on the bottom. Be in there, locked in. Okay, HD audio. All this HD audio. Sorry, I'm just looking for HD audio. Where's my book? Where's my book? My thing is straight. Okay, where's the HD audio? Of the board, thank you. Okay. HD audio, HD audio, where are you? Where is my HD audio? Okay. Sorry, I'm just going through. Looking at the manual here for the HD audio. There it is. F audio. Okay, so that's on number 14. Okay. 14 is located. Oh, it's on that box.
Okay, so it's on.
Oh, I see it. Okay. HD audio? You're like way low over here.
And I'm not kidding. It's like read. I can't barely. Said it was that one.
I'm gonna have to bring this down again. Saying that one's HD audio, so.
The other cords.
Nope, okay, cool. Bring this down. So, the one that I'm actually trying to do. So, this guy here goes right here. Apparently. I have to be very careful with this one. It's so hard because this is a Y spreader. It's also, okay, am I doing this upside down? That's probably why. Okay, so that's ready. I'm gonna pull through. I'm doing this upside down because. Oh, that's the TPM. Oh, it's a frick. I'm like looking for it, I'm like staring right at it. Okay, there it is. So it's the one that says audio on it. That seems like it's in snug. Good. Okay. So I got the audio, I got the USB, the front panel USB. I'm gonna SSD, I'm gonna do. This one's gonna be like right here, so. I wonder if I can do the. I'm gonna do the 90 degree one here. There. Because this is going to be really, really dumb of me, but I'm going to pull it through here. Actually, no, I can do it the other way. Let's do the other one. Let's do the other way. Because I can do. Oh, no. Let's do this one. I'm still trying to. Which connection I want to use for which. Because I don't want the two hard drives there. I want the ULR this way. So I want the L this way. And this is the cable that came with the thing. Oh, actually, let's do the bottom one. No, well, yeah, let's do the bottom one. There. I have to twist this way. Yeah. Okay. So there. So all the airflow is going that way. What other stuff can I do? I have no USB 3. That's the only front panel stuff, so everything else is like. That I have the 24. I have no system fans to worry about, which I'm fine with. So I need one more SATA cable. So I'm gonna bring this back up so you guys can see what this looks like on this side while I work on the other side. Because this is a little bit. Oh, right, I was gonna climb back down. Just a second. I totally forgot one last little bit here. Mr. Graphics Card, you're gonna go back in your little hole again. I thought I've done this so many times. Oh well, I. It's a learning curve. I haven't done this in years, so. A learning curve, I'm just gonna. At least I know where the audio is, where all this stuff is. It's very much a learning curve for me. So. Fine, I'll just bloody use this. Fine. You know what? So you're being a butt. To line up and then there we go. And then I twist until I can't twist anymore and then let's pop the other one back on. Little wiggly worm one works. Okay, yeah, that's done. Good. Okay, now I can bring this up. Holy crap. Ugh. So, well, I'm gonna attempt to
pull back all this stuff. You're gonna see this stuff come through. So I'm gonna do. Let's go with the. Where's the other kit? No, where's all the other. Where's my cable stickers? Do I only have. I hope I have another one of those straight ones. So that's what I need right now, is a straight one. And then what I'll do is I'll throw all the power cables and such in, and then this is almost done, finally. All I have left is to put the power cables on. Holy crap. I don't have a restart, which is weird on this thing. There's no restart. So I need a straight. Good. I need a straight away one because. Giggles. Oops. As you guys will seem frustrated here. I'm just gonna do all three of these on the bottom. Just for if I can get this one in straight. There we go. Make sure these guys are in. Good. And then I'm gonna put
this one underneath. I mean, granted,
I could have actually used the middle one. Oh, that's the not the second one. Here we go. Okay, apparently I didn't need that one. I just need this one. I just wanted to have one that was running. And my cable management right now is just terrible. So, there we go.
So, right now, I'm going to use the upside down. Should be able to use this one. Yeah. I see.
Okay, you know what? I will use the straight one. Praying aloud. I'll use this straight one. The straight one seems to be the better one.
There.
I'm gonna feed this one through, and this thing's gonna look like a mess for a while. In the back, because I have no cable management whatsoever back here. I have like cables everywhere, and it's. Oh, okay. Let's do this in order. So, 2, 3. So. Sorry, I'm just gonna. Put this one on the bottom. This one goes there, that one goes there.
So. Number 2, the one that's in the bay below is going to go there, and then the bay above is going to go on number 2. Or, yeah, on number 2. Hello, thank you.
All right. That's better. Now I have, a spot for all this cable management. And it's looking like a rat's nest back here. I will not lie, it does look like a rat's nest. Okay, time for. Oh boy. Okay, time to put all the cables that I don't need away. And whatever else I don't need. I can go garbage. I don't think I need that cable. No, I don't have RGB, so I don't need that. I don't need these cables. Hi. Yes, I'm using this as the. I'm building my computer. Well, I don't have the SSD yet, so. So I have everything but
And this is for full production, so I'm making sure that. Do you want an extra fan? Okay.
I like another graphics card, though.
What?
Nice.
Well, it's not top of the line either. It's what I need for doing my videos and stuff, so. Okay, next on my screen. ACIOs and I pulled all the slack, yeah. All my slack is pulled as far back as I can. Okay. And I've done all the hard drives and I've already wired them up. So, I can see this guy. So, this is facing down. So I want to go this way. This way on this side. Okay, so this is going to... This is why I have a small form factor. And that's like not existent, so all I have to... I made sure that this is like... should fit. Could have gone the other way, but that's right. I'm lining up my holes. Hole. So I have hole. Where is hole? There. I left the hole. I have 1, 2. I had 3 hole. And tell me I have to actually put this. Okay, where is my Seasonic one? Seasonic instruction book is probably upstairs. Oh, no, I have it here. I have this one. Should have brought my Seasonic one down. Okay. Hard drive now. I need power supply. Power supply. There we are. So I have to put this upside down. Okay. It is upside down. No, I literally have to put it upside down. Okay, I'm gonna. Okay, fine. Really? Nope, I have to put it this way. Okay. So why is it. But it's not. Do I have to put this? I'm sorry, I'm just trying to figure this out. Why? Do I not have a hole here? Oh, I have a hole. Okay, I'm looking at the wrong hole. There we go. Haha, I lined up all those holes. Good. Okay, so. Now I need those screws again. Where did I put box? Boxes and box. Okay. I need the screws that are in this box. Should I actually put these guys back under? This is why I have this. Blah. Okay, so. Don't need those cables, so they go bye-bye for now. Hey, man. All for the bloody hell's sake. So, there. Cables are away. So, what I needed was in the big, yeah, that's big. This big right here. They don't tell you what screws, unfortunately. But usually it's a. Okay. Install the power. I don't have it in here, so. I think it's 3216. At least this small. 1 to 3. Okay. 1, 3, 6 pin connectors. Okay, yeah. So, SATA cables, what do I have to do right now? I have the KS fans already, power supply facing downwards. I have that already done. Start plugging power. Okay. It's a full modular, so I can start doing this. This is all like super, super tight. So I'm gonna have to. For now, I'm gonna have to. You guys aren't able to see. So what I'm doing right now
is take this monstrosity of a cable. Where's this? So it goes. I have to go into that one there with this cable. So what I'm gonna do right now is get this power cable plugged in. It was a beast the last time I tried to do this. There we go. I can do this by feel anyways. So I have to do it here of all places. And this was like hard to get in last time. I was doing the benchmark. Let's see. I am in straight, so why are you not? Camera's gonna die. Okay, give me 10 seconds here. I'm gonna go grab my charge cord.